So next up is adding a phone. So adding a phone inside of the vehicle is pretty straightforward if we just hit the phone button. All right, so we press the phone button and we've got quite a few different options. So a number of phones that have already been connected. We can add in, we can go to settings, or we can cancel. So let's go add.
Bluetooth on from your device in order to search. On your device, select the name that matches vehicle name on the screen.
And we're just waiting for Ioniq 5 to show up. And it has, so we're just going to press that button there. Numbers match up. Hey, do we want to allow favorites and contacts to sync up? Yeah, we can allow that for now. All right, and we should be fully connected. So let's go back into phone for a second. Ah, there we go. It's downloading my contacts there. So we've got that. We've got my contact books. We've got my number there as well. We've also got our voice command prompt. And if we've got multiple phones connected, we can press the button along the very top right-hand side in order to be able to swap out phones as necessary. We do have this little slider there, so we press that, and again, that gives us our little split screen, or we can hide it as necessary. But it's very straightforward. So now we go back home. Now, we've got a few different options for media and things like that. So we can press the media button down there, and that gives us our main media there. We can kind of adjust in order to go to different media now. So we've got AM, FM, Sirius XM, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay are grayed out because I'm not currently connected. We've got my Bluetooth audio on my phone, and we've got sounds of nature, which we'll get to in just a moment. So we can close that out very simply. Now, actually, why don't we do this while we're here? So we're going back into phone, and as you can see, so as you can see here, we've got our phone we can hop back into, or we've got our phone projection. So as of right now, I'm not currently connected. So let's go through the process of setting up Android Auto and Apple CarPlay inside the vehicle. Starting off on the Apple CarPlay side of things, we're just going to take our USB cable and put it into the lower USB port. From there, opposite end of the cable, we're just going to plug ourselves in. Do we want to allow CarPlay while the phone is locked? Yes, we want to allow that. While using CarPlay, certain information will be available. We have to activate Siri. Perfect. And it should take a second there, and we should be... boom, connected, and beautiful full screen, which is amazing. But as you can see, we've got everything connected there. We've got my Apple Maps, we've got Google Maps, and we've got Waze, and we can use any of these systems. Oh, let's cancel that out. We can literally adjust as necessary here if we want to. So we can kind of do a pinch to zoom, we can swipe around, we can go back to the main screen there, we can launch into Google Maps. Live One is a radio app, so certain apps will work directly through this middle screen. Spotify, YouTube Music, things like that, you will have to connect over Bluetooth instead in order to play those. Like I mentioned, even if you had the YouTube app on your phone, you wouldn't be able to stream video through this middle screen whatsoever. But one of the nice things is that we do have a lot of flexibility as to how this thing looks and reacts. So if we go into our general settings on our phone, we go into CarPlay, we select the car, we can customize, and then from there we've got a series of different options available. So if you're a big fan of listening to your podcast, you can move it to the top. If you want your audiobooks up there as well, so we can kind of adjust as necessary. We can also delete things, which show up at the bottom here, but they're not on the screen now. So if you want to, you can add it back in. You can do a drag and drop on that hamburger button there to bring it back. And if you don't like what you've done, you've played around with it too much, we just do a reset in order to bring this thing back to the factory default instead. So very straightforward. Pressing that button will bring us back to this main screen, or we can press the Hyundai button to get back to this main screen instead. Hopping back into CarPlay, we can do that very simply. Back again and back, we can go back home. So very, very simple to do it. Now, if we ever want to adjust any of these settings, so we can do a couple different things. If we want to, we could forget this car, or we can disable CarPlay while locked directly on the phone. CarPlay, launching back in, and it's that quick in order to be able to reconnect to CarPlay if you've disconnected for whatever reason. And it's literally that simple, setting up Apple CarPlay inside this vehicle. Right now, setting up an Android device is the exact same process. If we're on this main screen there, all we're going to do is jump into our setup. We've got our device connections and a series of options available. So we've got our current device connections. We've got, as you can see, all the different phones that have been connected. That phone that I connected earlier, if we want to have it as our favorite, we can just do a drag to the top, and that's going to save that as a favorite device instead. We've currently got my phone and the music connected for it. If we want to, we can also go delete device, and we can delete this device if we want to. Just hit delete. Yes. And it should take a second. 3, 2, 1. The phone is deleted, and it's that simple to be able to delete the device. And now adding in the Android.
Bluetooth on from your device in order to search. On your device, select the name that matches vehicle name on the screen.
Perfect. Helps if I have this pulled up, and we've got the Ioniq 5 there. Perfect. Let's add in. And as you can see there, we're fully connected. So it's that simple to be able to do it. Exactly what we saw on the iPhone side of things. Now, on the phone, it's also asking, do I want to allow access to contacts, messages, things like that? I'm just going to hit no for now. But you do have the flexibility to add it back in if you want to. So we've got the options there of going through. If we hit the home button now and jump into phone, we've got the phone that I've just connected. So we've got my phone pad there, we've got my command prompt, and we can also swap out phones along the top. And then along the bottom, I forgot to point this out on the iPhone side of things, but we also have the phone name, as well as our current status for both the connection, as well as for our battery. So pretty straightforward. And we do have options. So if we hop back into our media for a second, so we go back into our media again, and we've got Bluetooth audio, which would be pulling directly from my phone instead. But very similar to the iPhone side of things, we can easily set up Android Auto. We just take our USB cable there, plug it into that front USB port, opposite end of the cable, right into the phone. And Android Auto would like to, so we're just going to hit next there. Okay. There we go. Perfect. So it took a couple seconds there, but it has launched in. Now, unfortunately, as you can see there, we are just going to be a split screen. So we don't have the option for full screen inside of Android Auto specifically. Apparently, there is supposed to be an update coming in late 2022, which will give us that full screen functionality, but it's not there as of yet. But we do have our Google Maps, and this phone does have Waze installed. Unfortunately, Waze as of right now is not compatible using Android Auto. So I wish it's there, unfortunately not yet, but we still do have all of our Google Map functionality there if you want to use it. We can jump into our podcast as well if we're using that. We've got music, notifications, and then our Google Assistant. And then we can also press and hold the button on the steering wheel in order to activate our Google Assistant. But we actually could have done that on the iPhone side of things for our Siri Assistant as well. So we do have quite a little bit of flexibility there. Pressing this button along the very bottom left will bring us back to this main screen. And then we can also press the Hyundai button along the very bottom there in order to jump back into the Hyundai main menu instead. So we've got quite a little bit of flexibility, which is always a nice thing. Now, we do also have the option of adjusting, so we can change out a few different settings on the Apple CarPlay or the Android Auto side of things. So on our phone, we're just going to hit or search for Android Auto. Once we do, we're going to go Android Auto. We've got our currently connected car. We can customize the launcher. So if we want to, very similar to the iPhone side. One thing to note, though, so let's hop into Android Auto, go back home. There we go. So as you can see there, podcast, I actually moved to the front, but it hasn't adjusted it there. We actually have to disconnect Android Auto from the vehicle. We have to restart our phone as well, the Android Auto specifically, in order for any changes to take into effect. So it's not dynamically going to update the same way it does in the Apple CarPlay side of things, but you still have the flexibility to customize it if you want to. Moving down, we've got our Google detection. So you could say, okay, Google. As you can see there, it launches in there. We can also say a few other options. We've got Google Assistant and a few other things that are available. So not as much flexibility as what we had on the Apple side of things, but there still is a nice amount of functionality inside of it if you are using an Android device instead. But I do like that we've got Google Maps that we can use. It's one of my preferred map applications if Waze isn't available. Then we can easily, as we saw earlier, press the Hyundai button to move back home. We can literally pull out, that's what she said, in order to disconnect that way. We jump into the phone again and we're back to the phone. We can go swap devices if we want to change it out to a different device, or we move into our home screen. We go into our setup. Oh, there we go. Setup along the bottom, device connections, and we've got our Bluetooth prompts. So if we want to, we can play or mute different prompts. We can go into different privacy modes. We've got our Bluetooth system info. So if you want to change your car name or the password, we can do it there. We've also got our phone projection settings. So we've got Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. Now, this is a little bit misleading because we didn't have that checked off, but it was still split screen. So that's a bug that's going to be updated soon. You're not going to be able to get full screen Android Auto inside of the Ioniq as of yet. We've got also split screen on the Apple CarPlay side. So if we want to go split screen, we would just go here in order to adjust as necessary. Then moving back, we've got device connections. And as you can see, all the different devices that have been connected, we can easily just select whatever device we want to delete. We just select, delete, yes. And 3, 2, 1, the phone is now deleted from the vehicle, and it's that simple, setting up both Android Auto and Apple CarPlay inside of the Ioniq.